Leading the category of traditional Irish landscape is this beautiful example by Paul Henry. It's entitled An Achill Bog and it's depicted here in an original Dawson Gallery frame. It was gifted to the original owners as a wedding gift, which is a very, very kind gesture indeed. Now, Paul Henry lived on Achill Island, as we know, from 1910 to 1919, after which he went to Dublin. By 1917, it saw him in a new employment as paymaster for the Congested Districts Board. And this role allowed him to travel a lot more freely. So he travelled a lot more to northern Mayo, where he would have depicted the landscape and worked them into finished canvases then back at his studio. This particular example here dates to the late 1920s, and we can actually date his work based on his palette of colours. This has a brighter key tone than some of his earlier examples, but still captures all the essence of the influence that Whistler had over Paul Henry. We see a very thinly painted sky in even tone, more impasto used in the mountain, which also indicates the direction of light. Similar impasto in the middle ground, but in the foreground we see much richer palette, thicker impasto, and the upward stroke of the turf stack bringing the foreground to merge well with that middle ground, and it really shows the exuberance of Paul Henry at this very height of his career. It is estimated at 30,000 to 40,000 euro, which I feel is a very attractive estimate for such a well-finished composition, incorporating many of the typical traits that we know and love by the artist: the blue mountains, the water, the turf stack, and boldly signed here, lower right, and it would be a wonderful traditional Irish landscape addition to any collection.